All right, guys, hello, happy new year, welcome to 2022, and welcome to the first video of 2022. I thought we'd start the year off by breaking down some walls and taking a look at the studio, the lab, if you will. You guys have often only seen one or two very specific angles of this space. We moved in here over a year ago now, so I've been working very hard, and I'm at a point where I really kind of want to show it to you guys. So, here it is. We're going to take a full tour and show you what goes on kind of behind the scenes in these videos. So come on in. The first thing we're going to take a look at is right behind you. And boy, oh boy, it is storage. So I haven't really gotten rid of a whole lot of machines that we've reviewed. It's a bit of a problem, but I just love having the physical machines to compare side by side instead of talking about something that I've had previously. So we're gonna have to do something about this at some point, but for now I've kept most of it. It's all here. There's an espresso machine on here, a bit of a hint for a future video. I don't normally have a light in these shelves, but I thought I'd put one on for the video. A shout out to my friend Renan, who gave me this little magnetic light. He has an FPV drone channel, so if you guys like FPV, go and give him a follow. I will link it down in the description. Another thing that was always in the background of our previous angle in the studio was this little shelf here. It's just an IKEA shelf. Something you didn't see is that it has always been filled with wine. It is kind of our wine cellar in our tiny little apartment. Okay, coming along this way, you see another angle that you guys have never really seen, which is this corner. And again, it is a whole lot of storage. Two more espresso machines. We have the appartamento, which has been relegated into this room because the decent, oh boy, the decent, is getting a whole lot of use out in the kitchen. I know a lot of you guys are waiting for the flow control video. It is coming. I was kind of waiting to have the decent in order to do that, to kind of compare a true high-tech flow control to one on an E61. We also have the Specialista down there. I don't know how long it's gonna be staying, but Specialista is down there. We have a little projector hidden in the corner and one of these little easels that actually used to be what our table was standing on. Now we have a sit-stand desk. Behind there, we have a little closet. It is full of boxes. We're not even gonna come close to going in there. Okay, an angle that you guys are pretty familiar with now, but it's still new, is the coffee bar. Originally, this wasn't even intended to be the background of the videos, but I'm just so happy with how it turned out that it's kind of transitioned into that. So I hope you guys like it, give me some feedback, but here is the brew bar. So we have the Rancilio Silvia on here. We have the Sino Art PT2 automatic tamper, which kind of also just acts as a nice background light. We have Malkonig X54. We have the Flare 58. The video is coming. If you guys have any questions about the Flare 58, please leave them down in the comments. I have not started filming that, but it is coming very, very soon. We also have the Goat Story Gina, which is another video that is coming. Again, if you have any questions, let me know. That video is coming. But overall, I'm really excited about this brew bar. I'm super happy with how it turned out, and it gives us some storage as well. This drawer is kind of the espresso drawer. I have portafilters, I have tampers. They're all organized by size and different machine. This drawer is kind of the pour over drawer. We have just different carafes. We have the Stag X stripper, a bunch of different things in there. Something you might be noticing in the background that isn't normally in the background is these two speakers. For those who didn't know, I'm really into hi-fi. I'm also into watches. That was kind of the original plan for this channel, was to do coffee, hi-fi, and watches. If that sounds like something that would interest you, let me know. But for now, we're sticking to coffee. But let me know if those things would interest you down in the comments. Another thing I'm really excited about is having a desk. As you guys saw in the decent unboxing, this is a sit-stand desk. It can come up to standing level where I film most of my videos. But I've also done a few recently where I have been sitting. And that's really nice because I can actually sit and edit my videos in the studio. I used to sit out at the kitchen island. This is so, so much better. I have a Herman Miller Aeron, and it just happens to be in a gray color that also matches the brew bar. I can't say that was intentional. I'd love to take credit, but I can't. Okay, swinging around this way, we'll kind of break down another wall. So that was the new set. And you might recognize facing this way was kind of the old set. So this is what you are more familiar with, the light in the background. This was pulled forward. This desk is actually on casters, which is great. And another thing is this new boom arm. So as I raise and lower the desk, the microphone raises and lowers as well. so I don't have to constantly be moving that back and forth, which is awesome. If you guys are into kind of photography and videography stuff, you might not know this, but I have all of my camera, lighting, microphone gear linked down in the description of all my videos. I'll maybe move that up to the top of the description for this one if you want to check that out. So we've got lots of exciting stuff to come. I hope you guys kind of enjoy this little behind the scenes look. I am super proud of this studio space, and it is all because of you guys. We wouldn't have this space, we wouldn't have all this gear if you guys didn't tune each and every week and watch. So thank you guys. I'm really excited for the new year, and stay tuned. There's tons of exciting stuff to come. Thanks for watching, and I will see you in the next one.